Good evening, and welcome to Chapin Hall here on the campus of Williams College. My name is Matthew Gold, and this is IO New Music. This evening's program represents our efforts to come back together and make music again this year, in spite and in the face of many challenges. Beginning the year, we had a lot to think about, of course, as everyone did, wondering, you know, what the semester would look like, whether we'd be here for the entire semester, whether we'd be sent back, sent away, and just how to make music together, how to share the same space and to communicate, share our sounds, and be together in that way. And the works on this program were an effort to confront that in a creative way. As a new music ensemble, we often play music that takes creative approaches to what you might consider to be the fundamentals of music making, and that call those things into question. So within that, we had a real opportunity to explore these restrictions and find ways to make music together. Each of the works on the program has some element that allows that and deals with it directly, whether it's spatial or temporal, or issues of sound, notation, coordination. They each explore that in some way, either explicitly or suggested some on the work that allowed us to use that in that sense. The works on this program, there are four pieces, the first by Linda Catlin Smith, then David Lang, Mario Diaz de Leon, and ending with a work by Betsey Biggs. I'm really excited about this program. Aside from all these musical issues that are in it, these are four composers whose work I'm really interested in, who I think are incredibly exciting and some of the most original voices working today. The first work by Linda Catlin Smith is called Stare at the River. And in this piece, she writes that it's primarily concerned with melody, but layered melody, with each of the instruments moving in its own stream. So thank you again, and we hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Okay, so the next piece we're going to play for you is David Lang's Little Eye. So this is the fifth movement from Lang's piece, Child for Ensemble. And the instrumentation for the piece is four percussionists and solo cello. So each percussionist has their respective instrument as well as a break drum, which is a found object. And so a found object is basically an everyday object that's repurposed as a musical instrument. And so in this case, these are literally parts of brakes taken from junkyard cars. And so this piece, it's named after the popular childhood game. And the way that the cello melody and rhythms are written, they're meant to ambiguate the sense of rhythmic pulse and create a dreamlike state. So David Lang's Little Eye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
A few more words as we reset for the last work on this evening's program. First of all, I'd like to take this opportunity, as always, to thank Jeffrey Miller and the incredible crew here. It's a group of students who, you know, usually set up stands and chairs and do all kinds of amazing things, but are now suddenly having to, you know, basically run a production studio. And yeah, it's a completely different thing, and they're doing an amazing job, and we're thankful for everything they do. And a few words about the last piece of the program. This is a work called Away by Betsey Biggs. And oh, look at that. What an amazingly fast setup change. So I'll keep it brief. The work is titled Away, and it became the title of this program. This was the first piece we played this semester when we were looking for a way to come back together and play. And I had known about this score for a while, and I wrote to the composer and asked her if we could take a look at it. And the work is, it's a graphic score of sorts that consists of a deconstruction of the old American folk song, O Shenandoah. And it's just based on pitches from that melody, but they're arranged in a graphic way, like, you know, essentially like a picture with arrows. And the players can make their own way through it, sharing their sounds with one another, listening to each other, following these arrows in the score to find different paths through the melody. So you never hear the notes in order necessarily, but they're all there, and the players find their own way through that. And with this kind of score, with this kind of piece, we could set up at a distance and play spatially without the same kind of coordination. It developed new ways of listening, even with that distance, and a way to play together and share sounds. And finally, I'd like to say, in thinking about the title of the work, Away, and the title of this program, you know, I kind of thought, what if we, you know, one way to look at it is it's about being away, it's about being apart. But another way is if we make it into two words, away, it could be, you know, for us, it was a way forward. It was a way to begin. And so we are thrilled to share the work with you tonight. Everybody here? All right, so thank you again, and we hope to see you again soon.